crushing everything and making it the same. This is the story of the many who are blessed with
different.
In the dream inside the strange giant's mind, the voice that spoke to the Trebum seemed different. It was less like a memory, more like something alive. But there were so many other voices too, lost in this place.
I remember the mountains of my home, the vast forests, the clouds hanging low overhead, the cities in the valleys where the rivers ran. I remember the faces of my children and the songs we sang when the stars rose high. But I have forgotten the names of all these things, and slowly one melts into the other. My children will become mountains, the forests will become songs, and then all will become one and be nothing.
Was something hidden in this place, and the voice wanted the Trebum to find it.
I remember a city built in the desert in defiance of thirst. When night fell, it shone like a jewel, and even the stars envied its brightness. Poets and scientists gathered from around the world, and its great observatories scoured the sky for wisdom and beauty. That is where we first saw the new star.
Each voice was a memory, a song from a forgotten time, slowly fading. But some of these memories were Trebon memories, memories of things that Trebon had once been capable of. Perhaps, the voice suggested, these could be reclaimed.
I remember how our towers stretched out to the sky, yearning for the stars. They were symbols of our best and our worst. I remember our voices echoing in the canyons as we fought for change, for a world that was different. Then it came, and the towers fell, and there was no more difference. Where are our voices now? Where are our songs? I only hear one, and it is eternal.
As the memories return to the treble, old abilities stolen by the cylinder were finally restored. But there was so much more. The voice had answers, but it was weakening. Frightening as it was, the treble would have to come back. This was a place of death and nothingness. There were no answers to be found here. The voice and their memories urged them to return to the lands of the living. A profound feeling of futility overcame the Trebon. Despite having miraculously survived their encounter with the mathematician, they were back to where they'd started. To make matters worse, ahead of them lay the cold and snowy lands of the tundra. Not a very nice place for Trebon, who were not meant to live in the cold. They would have to push forward against all odds and pray that they could find help. If the Trebon were going to deal with this terrible cold, they needed to find a mutation that would keep them warm. Their memories suggested that the answer lay in the odd little purple furball that grew where the beautiful snow corals rose from the ground. With this new pair of eyes, the Trebon felt, well, to be perfectly honest, they felt rather silly. But despite that, the voice in their minds told them, with these eyes, they could learn much about the creatures they encountered. The voice was glad about this. It was knowledgeable in the manner of animals, and now it could contribute its wisdom to their memories.
Thank you.
This time, the Trebon knew what they were feeling. Here was another servant of the cylinder. But what shape would this creature's evil take? It did not seem interested in the Trebon. The servant of the cylinder had released a swarm. Small parasites had come from within it and attached themselves to the creatures in this area. It was somehow using them to corrupt the tower, to turn its protective force into a trap. All Trebon hate parasites by nature, and they hated these even more. They would have to remove them, but how?